It's time for Live in Tallahassee, the region's number one source for entertainment news. Live in Tallahassee is brought to you by these local businesses: North Florida Woman's Care, Kraft Nissan, Brian Barnard's Flooring America, and the law offices of Johnny Devine. And now, here are tonight's hosts.
Providing you a recap of the fantastic Easter weekend. This is Live in Tallahassee, and welcome to an episode. Joel Silver and Howard here for 30 more minutes of what is happening in our region.
What is happening in our region, and it's a lot of excitement.
Oh my lordy lordy. The Easter weekend was amazing. We're actually recording this show early, as you can tell, during Easter weekend. So many activities in Tallahassee, and it was, I mean, we're right now at Island Wing Company. We'll be back here later to tell you what's happening. But Ann, it's a great time to be in Tallahassee. It's springtime.
It is gorgeous, amazing weather. Funny friends who you just absolutely adore and got to spend time with this weekend. So yeah. We love it.
And I'm in my Easter springy color.
I am not. I'm in black, unfortunately. Yes. But that was not planned.
It
was
we
just
know.
Casual. Sure.
We yeah. know.
Yep, yep, yep. But where are we right now?
I just told them we're at Island Wing Company.
Oh.
Ann hasn't been on the show in a while.
I've been so excited listening to all the fun and everything behind me and
right.
friends and loved ones.
But let me tell you what's coming on the show tonight, because oh my, do we have a good one for you. I told you right now we're at Island Wing Company. But coming up later in the show, we got people all over the place. You're going to need to see our friend Chef Art Smith, who is in Midtown. We love him. Check out who we ran into in the Lemoyne Chain of Parks. Marcia Dahl was there, and she was having a good time. We've got people all over that you're going to want to hear from later on in the show. Plus, a lady riding a horse, painting a picture of a horse while she's riding.
I'm trying to picture that.
I know.
Okay.
I know.
It should be exciting.
You don't want to turn away, because we're going to show you highlights in the middle of the show, and then at the end of the show, we're going to show you the entire painting process. All that on this episode.
I'm excited. I'm impressed. And we've got a ton of quick shots. We've got a ton of stuff just going on in the show, so I'm very excited.
But we start with one of our favorite stories, and that is the Varsity Club Golf
Michelle
Tournament.
Wilson.
That we do every single year. It's one of Ann's favorite events.
It is. I love Michelle Wilson. She does an amazing job, as well as all the other people who put this event together. And it's for a great cause. And it brings all of your beloved celebrities, as it relates to FSU, back into town if they don't live here already.
And I will tell you this. There has been one guy each and every year that we have assigned this story to. He likes the food. He definitely likes the drinks.
Sure.
And he was there once again, I think maybe for the third or fourth year in a row. Sketch Piers, take it away.
I'm all right. Nobody but about me. Why you got to give me a fight? Can't you just let it be?
It's always fun to get out here with these guys and have a good time and, you know, knock it around a little bit. We're not doing too well, but at least we're having a good time.
Go Noles. Love you, Michelle. Always do a great job. The Varsity Club, we all know what this is about. Florida State, let's go.
This is an awesome event. We love it every year. Weather's great, food's great, drinks are great.
I'm enjoying a great ride.
All right, I'm here with
Shane Calder.
All right, tell me what you're doing.
Well, we have, it's new to the golf industry. We have a air cannon that shoots golf balls, and we're on the 13th hole at Golden Eagle, and we're shooting it about 320 yards. and we're having the closest to the pin contest. And you just missed the winning it. We have one closest right now, about 6 feet from 120 yards.
So I made it at least top five.
I think you're in top five, yeah.
Joel, you saw it here. All right, I'm top five with this golf cannon. So, like, I mean, we've had so many celebrities come out. Like, just left of the pin. All right, but for, like, who's some of the celebrities that you've seen hit so far?
Well, let me. I gotta radio this in. This is one of the things I gotta do. Great shot. That is about 10 feet long of the pin to the left. Good shot. I think it beat you.
Crushing me. But I mean, we just literally witnessed a top three shot. I mean, this is a new technology in golf, and honestly, I'd start playing golf if we had a cannon for every hole. But thank you so much for what you're doing.
Thank you.
We've been doing this for a number of years, and it's always a wonderful deal, and thank you so much, and keep doing it.
It's always a lot of fun. We appreciate the Varsity Club having us out, Michelle Wilson, and thank you to Sean Shepard and Greg from Wahoo Seafood Grill for having me out to play today.
First of all, how adorable is Sketch Piers? He loves this story. He specifically asked to cover your event every single year.
And we specifically want Sketch out there. He does such a great job. It's almost like he's his own celebrity at our event.
He is, and his brother, Drew, is amazing, and he's at Ron Sachs Media, so we love him too. But anyway, so tell me more about why this is so important to you.
Well, it's so important to me because this is our 8th year doing this, and we're raising money for scholarships for all sports at FSU. And every year it keeps getting bigger and better, and we couldn't ask for a more perfect weekend this weekend with the weather being off the chain. And I mean, the community really supporting it. It just every year keeps growing and growing. So
do you want to give us any ideas or hints as to what we can expect for next year? Because you've got to keep outdoing yourself. It's a big deal.
Yeah, I mean, I can tell you the plaid party is in full effect. And as you saw throughout the evening, everybody is in their full-on loudmouth, crazy wild attire, so that's going to get bigger and better. Auction keeps growing every year. We were sold out both Sunday night and sold out at the golf tournament, so I expect the same thing for next year. So if you didn't participate this year in 2018, you better participate.
Was there a winner?
Absolutely. Was there a winner?
There was. Actually, our pro was Kenny Knox. And his team, which was my presenting sponsor, they won with the pro, Kenny Knox.
And presenting sponsor was who?
Was Resort Quest.
Nice. So anyways, thank you so much for including us every single year in this event. We love it. You do an amazing job. We just absolutely love you.
I love you guys. It wouldn't be the same without having live in Tallahassee at all of my events.
We're going to break. Stay with us.
Being a big has impacted my life primarily through awareness. Awareness that I could impact another child's life, another human's life, in a way that I had no idea existed.
Sit at any traffic light or pull into a Publix and you will see it. Tallahassee is a Nissan town. So if you're thinking of buying a car, don't do it until you stop into Kraft Nissan. Why? Our prices are that good. Model for model, I don't care if it's Toyota, Honda, Kia, they cannot match us price for price. Tallahassee is now officially a Nissan town. What are you waiting for? Come get yours at Kraft Nissan.
North Florida Women's Care offers the highest quality services for obstetrical and gynecological patients. We are a group practice of caring, industry-leading providers. We have the highest quality ultrasound equipment in Tallahassee. You can call or reach us online 24/7 at the patient portal for appointments, test results, billing, or to send a secure message to our nursing staff. North Florida Women's Care delivers the care you deserve and the trust you expect.
Welcome back to Live in Tallahassee here at Island Wing, having an amazing time as they start their inaugural Wingfest.
Unbelievable. Year number one, and it's already packed. So, I mean, I can tell everyone loves this restaurant already. So, this is just a sign of things to come.
Absolutely. We saw former House Speaker Dean Cannon here with his kids, just doing a run-through, saying hello, so that was fun.
All right. At the end of Quick Shots, at the end of this segment, we'll have some scenes from here. We'll show you what's happening. But let's jump into it and show you some other things happening around our area. And these are the things we call our Quick Shots. Okay, and Howard, we have so many to go through, I can't even imagine. What you're looking at here, this is the, you're gonna love this, okay? This is the Circle of Gold presentation for FSU Alumni Association. The recipients of this year's Circle of Gold, all the former First Ladies at Florida State University and the most recent four First Ladies on stage with a great presentation of their experience at FSU.
So I love to see women being honored.
That's
it's
right.
Just something awesome. It's personal. Go ladies.
It was a great time. Everybody had fun. And congratulations to everybody there. Scott Atwell put on an incredible presentation, and all your favorites were there. And so were there the presidents, and the presidents got to sit in the audience and watch as their first ladies were honored.
Do you want to name some of my favorites?
Yes. So Patsy Palmer was there, who it was Sandy D'Alembert's wife.
Oh, my
Jean goodness. Thrasher, who is, of course, our current president, John Thrasher's wife. The Dale Licks wife was there, who was the president when I was at Florida State University.
Wow.
And I mean,
like 50 years ago?
Yes, way back in history. So an amazing time was had by all. Let's take just a quick listen to one of them.
I learned that people will forget what you say. People will forget what you do. But people will never forget how you make them feel. And I just thought that was so wonderful for me to share with each of you, because I will never forget how I feel tonight. Thank you.
All right, Ann, we're heading over to WC Dover Farm now for this annual event that we love, the fundraiser for the Triple R Horse Ranch, which takes care of horses that are in need of help. And we love this one. You're looking at the beautiful grounds here at the pavilion at Dover Farm. The place was packed with all kinds of wonderful things. They actually had horse demonstrations. You can see them here showcasing some of the dressage and some of the lovely things they do. And a lot of people there had a great meal and a lot of fun.
I'm actually ashamed to admit that the word dressage was taught to me by Joel Silver.
We all love it. But Anne, here you go. And this is what I told you about earlier, the highlight of the night. Check this out. One of the riders on one of the horses that were there to support painting a picture, and you can see each time she comes by the picture, she swipes another line here, okay? Then the horse brings her around, she refills, she gets some more paint on her brush, and then she comes around again and puts another line on there. Now, at the end of this painting, you're not gonna believe this, it's a fantastic photo, a fantastic painting of a horse.
I cannot begin to explain how impressed I am by this. I don't know. I wish I had a hobby like this. It's very creative. It's very interesting. It's very out of the box. It's amazing.
It was unbelievable. Now, remember, at the end of the show, we're going to show you the whole process. So stick around, because we'll show you the entire painting process sped up, and then we'll show you the final product.
I am impressed at how smart animals are.
Oh, yeah. This horse was great, too. Okay, and moving on to the next quick shot. Now we're going to do some of the fun things that happened on Easter weekend. First, the Lemoyne Chain of Parks, their annual art and festival here, and a lot of people at the Chain of Parks.
This is one of my favorite events that they do every single year, and it changes from weekend to weekend depending on the year. But this particular weekend, amazing weather, lots of people were in attendance. Lemoyne has done such an amazing job impacting this community, so I'm very impressed with them. Hats off to everyone who helped organize this particular event and everything that Lemoyne does all throughout the year.
We promised you Marcia Dahl. Here she is.
Hey guys, oh my gosh, we are downtown Tallahassee. I got Gucci Doll with me. We're downtown here for the Lemoyne Arts Festival. And it's just incredible, the local talent here. The art, you have to come. You have to come now. Well, this is film, so this is not live. Oh, sorry about that. Sorry for what a tease I am. But great local artists here and such talent that we have right here in Tallahassee. And what a great idea to showcase the talent that we do have. What do you think, Gucci Doll? Gucci Doll is loving it. We're coming home with some artwork. Aren't we, Gucci? Yes?
She's great.
Okay, good. Well, a lot of people came out for this, which is exciting. We love our local events and a reason to come out and stroll downtown and look at the beautiful sights of downtown Tallahassee. Couldn't be in a better place today.
Marsha. Coming.
And you're not going to believe us. We have more to go. Let's go to Midtown for brews and burgers at the Brass Tap. This event's been going on for a couple years, and look at it now. It's built up to just an impressive event itself.
I've actually not had the chance to attend this because every single year that they've done it, I've actually had other things going on and I hate that I've missed it. However, all my friends who go absolutely adore this event and they plan their April around brews and burgers.
It's a lot of fun. We promised you Art Smith, famous chef Art Smith from Florida. Here he is now.
Hi Tallahassee, it's Chef Art Smith. So excited about FSU. We're going to bringing farm to table and fresh from Florida, right here in the capital city. You know, Florida is one of my wonderful places that I love to be. It's my birthplace, and Tallahassee is my home. I love Tallahassee. I love the food. You know, we're here at the Brass Tap today celebrating hamburgers and brew beer. Don't you love that? What better two things to enjoy? But most importantly, come to the beautiful Canopy City, enjoy great food and great people.
That used to be Oprah Winfrey's chef, Art Smith.
Yep, you're absolutely right.
So amazing guy.
Awesome. Yeah.
Amazing guy. And
everyone comes to Florida eventually.
He's got a culinary school. He's opening over in Live Oak, which is awesome. And that brings us, Ann, back here to Killarn. And you're looking at some of the footage of the place we're at now, which is Wing Fest. This is the fantastic new restaurant, Island Wing Company. The place is packed. Now, this is the first annual Wing Fest.
Inaugural, yes, very true. And one of the most amazing things about the Market District is how much they've built it up in just a few years. It's impressive what they've been doing here.
Yeah, so I mean the idea here is simple. Great music, great food, and great drinks.
And great people who attend these events.
Well, there you go.
Presence, company included.
Aw, you're making me blush.
Next up, here is a quick shot about Easter.
Easter egg hunting.
Hunting eggs.
Going Easter egg hunting.
Going out to get Easter eggs.
Because we have Easter egg hunt and they're everywhere. And then there's lots of candy and then there's a bouncy house and then there's a playground.
I love Easter hunting.
Today went awesome. We had plenty of kids. We put out 20,000 eggs, and I'm pretty sure they're all gone.
Actually, it's perfect. I like the trees around. It's shade, so we don't get all sweaty, you know, before. So we'll probably come out here every year.
Mommy, how many Easter eggs I got?
It's about 100.
I'd say about 30.
30.
I think it brings the community together. We have a lot of partners in the community that help and donate our grand prize items and a lot of stuff to make this all possible. So it really gives the community a sense of togetherness.
Thank you.
because I forgot all the Easter eggs.
Well, I'm gonna get a whole bunch of Easter eggs, like a whole lot.
Good.
I think we did pretty well.
What'd you get?
Oh, you got a sticker and a spinner thing.
Wow.
Just seeing the kids' faces, just running to find the eggs, and then when they find the grand prize eggs and all the candy, it makes me happy to see them happy.
Happy Easter to everyone here, and it's a beautiful day, perfect weather, and we as a family are going to get more than 25 eggs.
So, Ann, how about that? That's maybe a record of quick shots on one show.
Well, on AM break, Audra and I have talked about everything that gets packed into the month of April because the weather's amazing.
That's right.
The spring game. Lots of people are in town. You just do so much in the month of April. It's just really the month to get out and live and do stuff in this town.
It is the most wonderful time of the year.
The weather's awesome.
It is.
Yeah.
It is. All right. When we come back, more live in Tallahassee. We'll see you in a minute.
Cartwright, the owner of Ponderosa Junction. People ask me all the time, what is the Ponderosa Junction? Well, the Ponderosa Junction is a high-tech, interactive, highly entertaining shopping experience for home decor and furniture. You can browse through thousands of high-def furniture and home decor options on tabletop smart stations, and then you can insert the furniture dimensions into your simulated home environment in our augmented reality app to make sure it fits. Begin your journey into an exciting new way to furnish your own personal lifestyle.
Live in Tallahassee, back on the air, and Sun is getting hungry. We got to move it along.
He wants his island wing wings.
But remember this, coming up in just a moment, we'll give you more footage from the Circle of Gold alumni event where they honored the first ladies. And then at the end of the show, that horse painting experience, we're going to show you the entire painting being made.
Awesome, awesome,
but
awesome.
With just enough time to tell you about a couple of upcoming events. And the first one coming up, not this weekend, but next weekend, Doak After Dark, Blake Shelton.
Huge name. name, dating Gwen Stefani, lots of headlines with this guy, plus he's very good looking, she's gorgeous, everyone is so excited, oh, and he's a really good singer, so we're excited to have him in Tallahassee.
And I'll tell you this, live in Tallahassee cameras will be there, but I won't, because I'll be at another event, and get your tickets now and sign up and get ready, because it is time for the South Walton Wine and Food Festival in Sandestin, Florida. And this is a great, great event. Grand Boulevard, booths and booths of wine, great food, great wine, and they have some liquors to sample too, by the way.
You get the worst assignments.
This one is amazing and we love it. Put on by our friends at the Florida Restaurant and Lodging Association, who do such wonderful things in our region. But listen, if you can get over to Sandestin next weekend, so it's Friday night, it's Saturday, it's Sunday, and in addition to all that, there will be songwriters and Nashville songwriters from the country music capital of the world. They'll be there showcasing some of the great songs that they've written.
It has to be something pretty big to make you miss Blake Shelton.
I know.
Right.
Country music there, some country music here.
Absolutely.
It's going to be a fantastic weekend live in Tallahassee. We'll be working real hard to make that happen.
All right, let's say good night.
Good night, everybody. We'll see you next weekend.
We love you, Tallahassee.
Thank you to our sponsors.
Tonight really is a privilege. This is a very, very special night because there's a very special group of people we're going to induct tonight. The charter for the FSU Alumni Association Circle of Gold defines its membership as those worthy individuals who, through their service and achievements, personify the university's tradition of excellence. Tonight's induction will bring to 257 the number of individuals who have been so honored. Tonight we carry on that tradition by recognizing the contributions that all of our First Ladies have made to the success of Florida State Universities.
I always thought it was an honor to be the First Lady, and I really, thought Stan was a wonderful president for the time that he was there.